corner, and you have watchtower here with that view, okay, about the sea, that he can see different people that they come for that international market, remember? Okay, and also they receive a bad people that they want to attack them, because the people living inside the world rich, that I have told you at the bus, okay? A nobility, people living here, high society, and a shaman. Shaman, they were a spiritual guide and the doctors in that time, okay? And okay, we here, we going this way, this is the entrance, okay? We stop here, okay, to tell you about the different houses. We stop here to tell you about the watchtower, and then here in the front of a center of the Tulum. And I will tell you in each part a different stories, okay, about that site, okay? And this is exit, okay? So when I leave you after the tour, okay, a free time that I will give you the free time that we see each other at the restaurant, okay? Restaurant where we be now, okay? So I will show you the road, where we take the road to the exit. Don't worry, just to show you now, okay? And then I will explain you road, okay? And we stop here to enjoy completely that beach after the tour, okay? Good, this way please.
Sir,
okay, come on here. Closer, please. Okay. Look at that tree. That tree, it calls ceiba. Okay. It was really important for the Maya people because it represents a tree world that they believe a Maya people. Okay. It's a young tree. When it's an adult, it's 3 times the size. It's really huge one. Okay. And you have the same with the roots. Remember that here we have water in everywhere, okay? The cenotes, okay? And the roots, they're looking for water. And normally, okay, they have the same size as the tree, but inside, okay? And the roots represent the infra world. Okay, for the Mayan people, what they have, a 9 god that you have to test them before going outside to see light. I mean, you born. Okay, this part is a world where we are now, our life. And the top is representing God. Okay, sky, heaven. Okay, so listen something.
Oh wow,
it's
tallow.
It's empty. Okay, wow. It means that the tree words, they communicate between them. Okay, wow. Ceiba. Remember the names?
Yes.
Because I will do the test in the end. Okay, please, this way. The picture to tell you how was before Tulum. Okay. Now Tulum, you have plants, you have trees, you have grass, you have different things, greens. But before, doesn't exist, okay? Why? Remember that here it was a jungle. And jungle, it can be dangerous for them. We have tigers, we have panthers, and we have also the jaguar. And of course, snakes, spiders, etc. A lot of things can be dangerous for them and for us too, okay? So what happened? When they decided to build their future city, they cut off completely the jungle. And they put on it, okay, a white soil coming from calcium, this place. Remember, we have just rocks here. And we have a lot of calcium, okay? But what happened with the white soil is reflecting in the night with the stars and the moon, and they can see everything on it. In that time doesn't exist the light, okay? So they adapted themselves with a nature here, okay? The step that you can see here is not the origin for our comfort zone, okay? They made a different road zone, as you can see here. Around, they put a road and the jungle. You know the jungle, the first category, it means you don't have access. You have to cut off to go inside. And for the security, they put that road because they travel lots. Okay, when you receive the mercantile here, they take it and they go in every places. And when you see a different site that we have here, okay, in the south of the Mexico and also in the center of America, as I have told you. But they built it very higher than the soil for the jungle. Why? That the animals can't jump. Okay, and they put that white soil that they can see everything, for example, spiders, snakes. Okay, you see that they adapted themselves completely with the nature here. Okay, and they go for 3 or 6 months. Okay, good. Something else in that time doesn't exist, a bottle of water, but we have a lot of cenotes. What happened? They travel without water because they know that they have a different cenotes in the road. But they have to use a chiclet. Do you know the chiclet, what it is? Chewing gum?
Yes.
Okay. That chewing gum, we have a trees that we have resigned, okay? And we use it as chiclet, as chewing gum. It helps them for two things, okay? First, to clean and to protect the tooth, okay? And the second, they give them a lot of saliva, and they use it also for saliva, okay? The time that they find a cenote to drink water. That was interesting. And they travel only in the night, not in the day. It's too hot, okay? And you see here a different color. In that time, he used a colors to make everything a beauty, but not for the temple and the houses. There was always a reason to build a different temples and houses. Okay, but the colors that they have used for the beauty, but they have used the same thing, color very strong, red, blue, green, yellow. Okay. Black to show that the others what we have again. Okay, good. We can-